How does the decision, karma, of a national leader affect the destiny of the nation, the people of the nation, war, partition, migration, etc.?
How do we make decisions? We make decisions with free will, and we have built in our ideas about what is good, what is bad. This is a division made by the mind, which establishes a moral code of good and evil, so that we can use free will for doing good things or bad things. As it happens, the moral code that we use is created by our experience here. Wherever we are born, the parents, the school, the friends, siblings, peers, all those affect us and teach us what the moral code is. So we grow up with that moral code. A moral code becomes as if it is a code written by God Himself. Moral code changes from country to country, culture to culture, age to age. It's kept on changing. That is why you cannot say there's an absolute moral code at all. But in terms of relative moral code, there are. We know to kill somebody is murder. But if you kill your enemy, it's an honorable thing. Same act. There are so many acts that we are making them dignified, which would ordinarily fall into the other category. When we go through life, our karma is based upon our understanding of this moral code, which is registered inside the mind, in a corner of the mind. And that corner of the mind where it registers, we call conscience. Not conscious, conscience. Conscience is constantly speaking into our head, telling us what is good, what is bad, all built up on our upbringing and so on. So that is why when we make certain decisions, it is not possible always to justify by some other moral standards, but it's only justified by the moral standard where you are there. As it happens, the moral standards laid down by some culture at some time and in recorded version comes down heavily, and the parents of a child are inculcating those moral values in the child. It's very hard to live with that moral code. Moral code was set up very high standards, and mind does not want that standard. So what happens is that when we want to live that moral code, we do not follow it. And we are constantly committing what we call sin. We are constantly committing sin, wrong decisions we are taking because we are not following that moral code. When children come, we teach them the moral code that is standard, and they watch us betraying that moral code. Children learn from what they are watching, not from what we are preaching. We preach them the moral code, the standard moral code, and yet they are working on what they are seeing their parents do, and their uncles are doing, what others are doing. So their experience becomes like rebelling against their own parents, their own, and so the problem gets even worse. So generation after generation, this is happening. And when I was talking to you about carrying guilt, the guilt is being carried because the moral standard which were laid down way back by some are being tried to be enforced, we can't follow it, and we feel that we are carrying guilt with us. So it's not really necessary. So these national leaders and all, those who have to work, there are so many leaders who are working and have to give orders in war, they think they're doing the right thing. Imagine the terrorism going on. If you ask a terrorist, why are you doing this bad thing? He said, what bad thing? I am doing the right thing. My boss told me, if I kill so many people, I'll get a much better place in heaven. All the same moral code setting from that religion, from the old text that has been brought up. So that is why the national leaders who affect us even more, they are following something which is very different from what we believe in. So that is why there's rebellion, societal changes take place because of that, and a lot of other things. The only good thing is that no matter what is going on around you, no matter what your karma is, so long as you are seeking the truth inside, you're seeking the ultimate truth, in the worst of circumstances, a master will appear. Masters are known to have appeared in the prison of people who are committed in prison for something heinous they have done, and masters have appeared there. Masters have taken care of people whom we would reject as criminals, and they've taken them up. Great master himself had one person appearing in his life who was a robber, gangster, and he belonged to a gang. They are committing these evil things of killing people. And since the gang was also interested in looting property, thefts, they found out that the dera in which Great Master was working was having a building set up. At top of the building, there will be gold lining on the minarets on top. So people were willing to donate cash and jewelry. Women took off their gold jewelry so it can be used on that building. It was all being stored in different places. So much jewelry was brought in by all the disciples because it's to be used on the top of the building there. Big sentiment about it. This gang heard that they have a lot of gold sitting there. Doesn't seem to be a very well guarded place. So that's a good place to go commit robbery. They sent one man to go and do reconnaissance where the gold is kept. Then we will go in our truck and loot all that gold and bring it. So this man, whose name was Shadi, they called him Shadi. By the way, Shadi means marriage, okay. This man came to the dera and at a time when Great Master was giving a discourse. So he knew everybody will be there, so he'll go and check where the gold is. And he found a house in which there were children playing. He said, children, what are you doing here? Oh, my mom said, don't move from here because we have stored the gold here. He said, where is stored? In that basket there. He said, I have never found an easy target like this. He went to another place, some women were there in that another house. Why haven't you gone to listen to the satsang? Great Master is giving a discourse. No, we are staying here, taking care of the gold. Where is the gold? It's locked up there, we don't touch it. Wow, so easy. A thought came to this man. What kind of master is he? That when he teaches something, people don't bother about their gold, they don't bother about their wealth, just to go and listen to him. They left this wealth in the hands of the children and old ladies here. What kind of master is he? What does he teach? This thought came. And as the thought came, he said, I'll go and check what's happening. A small crowd of people were sitting. So he went and stood at the back. When he sat there, Great Master was giving a discourse and he's praising the power of initiation, the power of the word that comes through us, flows and pulls us all the way up. He says, that power, that naam, is in everybody, including gangsters and thieves. Man got shaken up. How does he know I am here? So he waited for the discourse to be over and he went straight to the master before master could get up. How do you know I am a robber? He says, oh, I don't know you. Who are you? He says, no, you know me. You pointed at me. You looked at me and said even robbers and gangsters have that. He said, that's nothing big thing. I say it every day. It is not meant for you. No, no, I know that you are trying to now back up. I know you found me. How did you know I am this? To cut a long story short, he applied for initiation, did not go back to his gang, and Master accepted him. Not only accepted him, he was virtually his traveling companion and guard. Traveled everywhere with the great Master went, that Shadi, and did so much meditation. The whole passion he had for robbery, he transferred into meditation. Great Master said, you have to do some work, because this is not a freebie living in the Dera. He said, but I never learned to work. He says, even when you go to rob people, you must be learning something. He says, yes, we go in the truck and I am the expert on the electrical side. If our dynamo breaks up, then I know how to rewire it and put it back in there. Great said, good, do that work here. So for the first time, a generator was put up, installed in the Dera, and it was an old type of generator where there was a big leather strap and we had to pull the leather strap to start it, to start the engine, and then it would just like this go tuck, tuck, tuck and keep working and produce some power. So the first line he drew of power in Great Master's house, so first time we saw a lamp there lighted up. So I remember this because I used to sometimes go and pull the leather belt of it and became good friends. Now this man had such wonderful experiences in life. Totally turned. Great Master accepted that robber with as much affection and love as accept anybody else. So masters operate on a very different level. But people have to go through their life. Nations are led by leaders, and leaders lead to these kinds of activities in their belief they're doing the right thing. In the belief that's what the best. Two leaders can think completely different values, but whoever is in power uses the value of his moral code, not the other.